Okay, here we are back in Legend of Heroes, Trails in the Sky, second chapter, specifically in Ruin. So, in case you're wondering what all happened while I was off camera, I went ahead and played in the casino. I figure you guys probably weren't interested in seeing me play blackjack. The strategy for that is easily available online. As far as I know, it plays exactly like any other game, so there's no real trick to it. But anyway, we go to Metal Exchange. We can buy metals here. You can see they cost 5 Mira apiece. I went ahead and bought 10, because I'm cheap. And when we get to prizes, you have your options here. The first of which we need is the Gambler Jack. So we're going to go ahead and pick that up. Then you can get a better fishing rod if you so choose. You can get a poison accessory, a blind accessory, a faint accessory. But the thing that I want is the long barrel, because I don't know where you can find one of these, and it's very helpful for Tita, or Olivier, or anyone else we get that uses a gun. So if you notice my metal count in the bottom left corner, I did go ahead and build all the way up to around 1200. That way I can get the Gambler Jack and the long barrel. And I still have 100 left over in the event I want to come back, or if I can come back for something else. In case you didn't know, the max bet for the blackjack table is 100 medals. So, the next place we need to go is the hotel. That's the casino bar. I think it might be the blue building. Yes, here we go. We're looking for room 101. Excuse me, can we have a moment? Sure, what's going on? You wouldn't happen to be Santos, would you? We saw your request on the board. Oh, your bracers. Finally, I was getting worried. If you're free, I'd like to get right down to business. How about it? Yep, we're good to go. So what's the job? Here's what I need. I want you to take a photograph of something in Sephiroth Tower. And that something is specifically on the roof of the tower. Sephiroth Tower, huh? That old room just off the Orient Causeway, right? Bingo, figured you know about it. What do you want a photo of the tower for? Is it for an editorial, maybe? No, not at all. I was dispatched by the History Museum in the capital. This task is for research purposes. Ah, gotcha. It's an academic investigation. Bingo again. I'll admit this isn't exactly your run-of-the-mill research, though. Run-of-the-mill? Let's worry about that later. First, let's go over the details of the job. Sorry, got a bit sidetracked. How much have I said so far? You want us to climb to the top of the tower and photograph something. We just need to know what that something is. Okay, so there are these mysterious objects on the roof of the towers. We know they're ancient artifacts of some kind, but outside of that, we've got nothing. Without much else to go on, the only thing we researchers can conclude is that they're devices of some kind. Actually, I might have an idea of what you're talking about. They look like weird pedestals, right? Oh, you know about them. Bingo, bingo, bingo. They look exactly like pedestals. Cool, then yeah, I've seen them around before. I don't think they work anymore, though. Actually, about that. That might not entirely be true. Huh? The device on Sephiroth Tower has reportedly been activated. What? It's actually working? The museum's received a report about that from a very reliable source. I doubt they were mistaken. Interesting. So, that's why you wanted us to check this out so quickly. Exactly. Anyway, we need to record the current state of the device. Talk about spooky. Yeah, probably a good idea to look into it. Is the device dangerous? We don't suspect it poses any danger for now, but you never know. But you can't say for sure. Anything could happen, so be very careful. Of course, I've got no intentions of letting my guard down. Just to double check, you only need a photograph of the device in question, right? Yep. Please bring the photograph straight to me. I'm going to lend you a camera, too. I'll need you to return it once you're back. Alright, I'm counting on you. This is pretty clunky. Well, yeah, if you want research quality, you need a hunk of machinery like this. Oh, by the way, I've already set the photo cords. All you need to do is snap the shutter. Yeah, got it. Okay, one more time. I need to go to the top of the tower, take a picture of the device on the roof, then return here with the photo and return the camera. That about the size of it? Perfect. And one more thing. No need for fancy or tricky angles. A simple composition for the photo is best. This is for research purposes only, so try and get the most head-on shot that you can. Okay, keep it simple. No problem. Can't wait to see the photo. Stay safe up there. So that's probably where the bonus points come to play, just based off of how well you get the picture. Now, the next order of business is we need to go to the docks. We're going to move the White Shadow storyline forward a bit, and then we'll do the monster exterminations as we move forward. I forgot to mention that there is a food item inside of the casino for you to buy. So, if you're interested in getting all the recipes, you do need to get that. I'll show what that is in a second. And I am going to eat the sea breeze soup just so I can get the recipe. Now, sadly, that did cost me a lot of money, but I think I can deal with it. So, there we go. So, in terms of recipes, the Azalea Kiss that's inside the casino bar. I meant to show that while I was there, but I kind of forgot. Ah, is that you, Lloyd? Oh, it's you guys. How about it? Already tried out your odd? No, not yet. I had some places I needed to go. I see, I see. Well then, want to check out a spot nearby? I know a really great location. Really? Yes, please. Hey, weren't we going to ask the Ravens about the ghost? Of course we were. We can make a short stop, right? Please? Fine, hurry up and get it over with. No worries, it won't take that much time. Let me show you, follow me. This is the spot you were talking about? Yeah, look at the surface of the water. Ripples probably tell us about fishing places. See, there's a ripple in the water, right? That's a sign you can pull up fish here. Should be able to find them in most bodies of water, so be sure to keep an eye out on your travels. Okay, so basically just pay attention to the surface of the water. Got it. Now, enough about how to find fishing spots. Next, let me give you this. Five something or another. This is bait for fishing, but it's not sold in stores, so you'll have to find it on your own. You're dropped by monsters, though, so a bracelet like you shouldn't have any problems. That's good to hear. And that's about it. You'll just have to find out the rest by trying stuff. Got it. Thanks for all the help. My pleasure. It's all part of being a member of the Fisherman's Guild. Well then, catch you later. I expect great results. You know what? Let's try it once. Spare the rod. Progress rod. Now, I don't know if this has changed since the first chapter. Kasago. And a juicy bone. Okay, that satisfies my curiosity. Now we need to find the ravens. I don't actually remember where their hideout was. I thought it was in one of these warehouses. You can see the election posters. And yes, it was. Man, I've been feeling worn out lately. We've been working like dogs at train, but it still doesn't feel like we're any stronger. I don't get why we're having trouble with random fucking monsters on the roads. It isn't just us, though. Everyone's been saying the monsters are getting really dangerous lately. Like, everything's gotten a couple times more powerful than it used to be. It's freaky. Now that you mention it, yeah. Whatever, how about we have a night in the town? First one we've had in a while. We can hit up the Levantar in the North Block. How's that sound? That place with the remodeled second floor of this casino now? Aw, yeah, that sounds great. Especially since I hear the dealers are hot chicks. Maybe I can show them my strength at poker, if you know what I mean. Now that's the plan. Carter's out of town, so if you want to cut loose a bit, now's the time. Do you seriously think you can get away with that? Agate? What the hell is this? I hear all about how you've improved, and when I show up, you guys are acting like this? It's just a joke, man. Totally a joke. Hey, wait, isn't that... That's that newbie bracer chick, Estelle. Hey guys, been a while. We last met at the tournament, I think. Yeah, sounds right. Oh man, we watched you from the stands after our fight all the way to the finals. You were incredible. I've fallen for you all over again. Thanks? Anyway, we're here for a reason. Guild business. Is the guy who saw a white shadow here today? White shadow? You mean... Yeah, they must mean that. You know what I'm talking about then. So spit it out already. Stop wasting our time, it's valuable. Wait just one damn minute. Where do you get off making demands like that? Huh? You're pissing me off. You abandon us, leave us in the dust to become a bracer of all things. A thuggin' law whore. And you come back to us only when it's convenient for you and expect us to tell you whatever. Well, you can just piss right off. Eve, Rocco? You're a prideful son of a gun, Rocco. Same as ever. What do you want me to do then, huh? Get down on the ground and beg? You gotta fight us, here and now. What? What? Why? Dude, calm down. Shut it, we need to settle this. You win, we'll tell you what you want to know. If we win, you don't get to act like the puffed up kingfish no more. Suits me just fine. Let's see just how tough you guys have gotten. Alright, you three, come get some. Oh man, why did things turn out like this? But hey, we get to find Estelle again. I don't know if that's really the point here. Okay then, don't expect me to hold back. Now that I think about it, I didn't really look around to see if there were any armor and weapon upgrades. I'm gonna let them come to me because if you notice they have that, I don't know which one to focus. But one of them has a strength or crit boost. Strength boost. Which he used to buff an ally. Quit being lazy. Not bad. Even though I didn't... I need to look at Agate's magic stat. Whoa. Okay, ooh. Damn, he packs a bunch. Don't let me catch you slacking again. Chain. Sideswipe an enemy. Yeah, I can only hit one guy with that. Let's spiral edge him. He's dead! Yeah, we got an EP heal. Ooh. Yeah, I want to steal that. Has he recovered yet? Okay, the turn belongs to Estelle. I'm gonna keep laying into the guy that's right in front of me. Damn it, I wanted Agate to get that CP heal. Flame Smash! It is entirely possible they could kill Estelle if I can't finish one of them off somewhat soon. I am at a bit of disadvantage here. That sucked. Okay, looks like their strength buffs have worn off. No, they're not lined up properly. I'm gonna have her continue casting. Actually, I should heal right here, just in case they do buff themselves up. Plus, this will give the strength turn to Agate. This is gonna be fun. So, we're gonna hit him with another Flame Smash. Perfect. We can steal another turn. Another solar. We're going for Rocco, I guess. Okay, that did not interrupt. Good. Sadly, if they're like in the first game, they can revive one another. And I have to take him out here because he knows he's going to get a big strength boost. So we're going to hit him with Dragoon Edge. Sadly, that will just give the strength turn to Rocco instead, but he's charging up. I can interrupt him with Heartbreak. Soul Infusion. That's a heal, I think. 300. And he's channeling once again. So I'm gonna Flame Smash them, since I might kill him here. That wasn't good. Oh no, never mind. And he's blinded or something, I don't know. Unfortunately, he's really healthy. I'm gonna have to steal the turn. So, I'm going to hit him with this. We'll see if this delays his. Actually, I'm just gonna play it safe this turn. Sadly, I do want to keep Agate's CP up in the event that I did run into Shiny Palms. So, they were worth chump change. Decent payout, I definitely needed that Wind Sabbath. God, you guys are strong. I give, if I had a white flag, I'd be waving it. Damn it! Guess it wasn't total BS that you guys were in the tournament. Still aren't putting enough into it, though. Even so, you guys are really good for civilians. Like, really, really good. Why not stop wasting your time here and become bracers? What? Bracers? Us? No way. The guild doesn't discriminate. Agate became a bracer and so did I, and I started out as a clueless kid. You guys should be able to do it, no problem. Don't make promises you can't keep. A bracer's more than just hired muscle. There's a lot of jobs that need more than just mindless fighting. You should know that well enough for yourself. Well, yeah, but even so. Yeah, that's right. Fighting's just about the only thing we're good at. Should've known nothing would be that simple. Anyway, a deal's a deal. I'll tell you what you want to know. Alright, let's hear it. Like we said, we're looking for the guy who saw a white shadow. We heard that one of you saw it. Yeah, someone did. He ain't here today, but you're looking for Belden. He joined about a year ago, long after Agate left. Might have seen him before, though, Agate. Yeah, I think I did. We talked a bit when I came by on that last case. Belden hasn't been by since seeing that thing, actually. I heard a few people say that he's stuck in bed from shock of seeing the ghost. What? Do you mean he was cursed, doomed to die, suffer forever? Don't know about that, but I do know he was damn scared. He's always been a sort of a spineless rich kid, though. So what's he doing pretending to be a punk if he's got a nice family? Whatever. We'll hit him up for the details. Where does this kid live? It's a big place to the right of the mayor's mansion. Some little fart named Norman who owns the joint. Belden's his oldest son. To the right of the mayor's mansion. Got it. Thanks for your help, guys. Okay, now we know where to go. Let's meet this Belden dude. Sounds good. See you guys. Don't get in any crap just because you're bored. Shut up. You guys keep it up and stop by again sometime. Hopefully without beating us up next time. Keep up the good work, Estelle. Now, unfortunately, I don't remember where exactly the mayor's mansion is, but I suspect... No, it's over here, I think. Okay... So it's not there. Okay, maybe they mean over here. Is this that Belden dude's home? Just to the right of the Maris mansion, looks like the place. Welcome. I'm sorry, but my husband isn't home at the moment. He's busy at the hotel. I would ask that you go see him there. We're not actually here to see your husband, ma'am. We were hoping we could speak with Belden. Oh goodness, you're here for Belden? I'm sorry, I thought you were here on election business. Election? Wait, ma'am, is your husband? Yes, my husband is Norman, one of the mayoral candidates. He's using the top floor of the hotel as his election headquarters, you see. The supporters are doing whatever it is people working for an election do up there. Okay, I see. We're here from the Bracer Guild, actually. But you kinda wanted to ask your son some questions, if that's okay. The Bracer Guild? Oh no, has Belden done something wrong? No, ma'am, nothing like that. We believe he may have witnessed something strange, though. We'd like to ask him some questions if he'll let us. Something strange? He didn't tell you about what he saw, ma'am? I'm afraid not. Happy to have him home for the first time in ages, but he's barely spoken to me since he got back. My husband's time is so dominated by the election that he won't even talk to his son. I see. Do you mind if we talk to Belden, ma'am? If he's got some problems, we can at least let him talk about them. Sounds like a great idea. Please, go ahead. Belden's room is on the second floor. I assume that's him? Excuse me, can we talk to you for a sec? What the hell am I doing? Came running back home just because Dad ain't here. I'm pathetic. Hey. Look at people when they're talking to you. Eh? Whoa. Who are you guys? Come on, Belden. Don't tell me you don't know me by reputation, at least. Agate? What are you doing in my house? I have some questions for you, and your old lady let us in. Got some time? I guess. What did you want to ask? Well, we heard you saw a white shadow recently. We were wondering if you mind telling us about it. That. I'd rather not talk about it, to be honest. Anytime I remember too much about it, I just get scared all over again. The heck is this? You're a raven, man up, talk already. I'll talk. Agate, stop scaring the poor kid. He doesn't need to wet himself. Hey, he's talking, right? Come on, details, make with him. Okay. I was living in the warehouse where the crew hangs out until about a week ago. I usually only come back here for food, see? I slept over there, you know, so I could chill with my bros. You've got to be kidding. How in the name of the goddess could you not want to live in a big, comfy house like this? Although, didn't you used to live like that too, Agate? Don't change the subject. So, you were with the crew. What happened? Like I said, it was a week ago. The crew was all boozed up and asleep, and I woke up for some reason. Thought I'd go outside, feel the night air, you know? Then I saw it. You mean, the white shadow? Yeah, a white shadow floating up in the air. It was in some kind of old-fashioned get-up, cape and all. And it was dancing in the air. That's rather specific. Sure you weren't just drunk, tired, and seeing things? No way. That scared me right out of being drunk, and I tried to scream, but couldn't even do that. As the thing flew off to the northeast, I ran to the warehouse yelling and woke everyone up. That just got me a punch from Rocco, though. Okay, I see. So when did this happen? Do you remember? I guess around 2 in the morning? Now I remember the whole thing. I came home to try and forget all that. Now I get why you ran home. You just didn't want to sleep in some place where you'd seen something scary. You're a failure of a punk, you know that? You'd be better off just quitting the Ravens and staying home. Yeah, I know I'm not cut out for it. But well, I just can't face my dad. He's busy with the election and not home much, and that's why I came back, but once the election is over, I'll have to face him, one way or another. And if he manages to win, my life will get even more restrictive. So basically, you're just running away from something you don't like. Well? Yeah, and you damn well know it, too. The answer, genius, is to find your own answer and stop relying on other people. I'll tell your old lady the same thing. Agate, we're done here. Estelle, let's go. Right. Belden, thanks for talking to us. Yeah. I guess we don't have to talk to her. She's been home for the first time in ages. Can't go through the plants. and they said northeast. Now, can I open a bigger map? They said northeast, so does that mean towards the Genus Royal Academy? Our quest takes us to the Sephiral Tower, which is probably where I should go next. Then I can hit up the orphanage in Minoria. The one reason why I'd want to go to Minoria sooner is I don't know what all food items I have to get for Orvid, but I'm thinking I probably should go to the tower. So I need to come back up here to get to the exit to town. Wait a second, this is the landing port. Can we get out over here? Church. I actually do want to look at the weapons real quick. 10 more damage. Ooh. So Olivier may be joining us soon if there's a gun here. That's a pretty big boost. Let's get a fiber vest. Wow, that feather brooch is kind of expensive. Yeah, I think I'm gonna pass up on the rod. Frame rate dropping, that's just the game itself lagging. Like I said, there are technical problems with the game still. Thing is, I don't really remember where Orvid is. Or where he's supposed to be. In case you're wondering, yeah, I'm gonna kill that. Okay, that's a bit disappointing that all the chests say the exact same damn thing. So, let's go. If you notice, they're gonna get a strength turn right off the bat. I don't think I can steal this anyway. They're weak to fire, if you didn't see the stat breakdown thing. Okay, good, he moved within range. I might be able to hit two. Yeah, only two. Estelle will get a heal here. And these things are really, really fast. I'm gonna steal the crit turn, actually. See if I can kill this one. This boosts the defense and agility on them, so they get to attack even faster, and I deal less damage than before. I'm gonna leave the one at full health alone and hope that the crit here really does a number. This could kill Estelle. And odds are she is dead just due to sheer speed purposes. I'm gonna see if I can kill this one real quick. I need to use the big one. Next order of business is reviving Estelle so I can get this show over with. I don't know how much a Celestial Ball costs, so I want to use the Azalea Kiss. They can poison you, by the way, that's what the resist means, in case you were wondering. And if you didn't notice, his buffs have timed out. I'm probably gonna need to rest inside the village, though. Spiral Edge him to try to delay his turn a bit, or whiff entirely, that works too. And I need Estelle here to heal. Aggie can take that. Meantime, we're gonna Firebolt him, potentially for the kill, we'll see. If not, Aggie will finish the job. There's no one left to buff, dude. You're dead. And that's a decent payout, especially with some compared to what I've been having lately. Really nice Sabbath payout. Mission complete. Hard loafers. So, are these shoes really worth all the hassle I went through? Yes, yes they are, women only. Oh, that's another thing I forgot to point out, I think, with the whole Agate Shara choice. If you take Shara, then obviously you have to pass on all the male-only stuff. If you take Agate, you don't have as many constraints for your equipment. So once I hit Orvid, I will stop for this sitting, but I'll splice more footage in. I'll worry about the chest on my way back. I'm a little pressed for time at the moment. So I don't know where exactly he is. Okay. Okay, they don't even sell Celestial Balm. That's a little concerning. They have Reviving Balm. That's the next best thing. And this actually is cheaper than the Azalea Kiss thing. I'm going to buy two. That way I still have some money, because I may end up having to buy ingredients for Orvid. You need five of those for the Azalea Kiss. I forgot one good thing, though, is you could end up cooking one. White Magnolia, I may need my money here. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm looking for the... there we go. Whoa. Holy crap, I can't afford this stuff. Do I even have anything to... how much are my time sepeth worth? If I want to sell five. If I want to sell 45, I can get 900. And now their actual recipe, 600. I'm gonna sell more Time Sepeth. Okay. We got got the recipe, and I don't actually see any change in my stats. That sucks. Talking about the rebuilding of the orphanage. For those that don't remember, Delmore burnt the place down because he wanted the real estate. Yep, this is... What's up? Oh, Joshua and I had lunch here a while back, you see. Just came back to me is all. Right. Don't be like that. It's not like it's a memory of some great tragedy or anything. I was just a kid who didn't really understand her own feelings. I totally forced Joshua to let me feed him, not even caring if anyone saw. He must have really been sick of me even then. You're still a kid if you ask me. How about it? Need a sec? No, I can't stop now. Can't let myself stop now. Besides, we need to head over to the orphanage. I want to see Teresa and ask about this white shadow. Right, let's go. Sunday school. Hey, visit the Bracers. Alright, check out the orphanage. We're on our way there. Got some stuff to check out. Got some kind of case. It's not a case, don't worry. Good to hear. Relax in the village, you're always welcome. We'll stop by later. Orphanage first. Okay, Orvid has to be in the restaurant. Let's go upstairs. There he is. Got a minute? What a surprise. Do you remember me? I asked you to do a job for me a while ago. What? You know him? Yeah, he's a merchant. Kinda. It really has been a while, huh? Yes, last we met was before the birthday celebration, I believe. If you don't mind, I'd like to get things underway immediately. Do you have the time right now? Sure, no problem. What's the job? Listen carefully. I'm currently putting together a list of ingredients obtainable across the entire Ruin region. Problem is, there have been lots of dangerous monsters out there lately, and I've been able to go out investigating on my own. That's where you Bracers come in. I'd like for you to assist me. Sounds easy enough. What do you want us to do specifically? First, take a look at this tentative ingredient list I put together. Savory pinion, leathery tail, gummy eyeball, monster carapace, beast flesh, prickly seed, fish fillet, clear gelatin. I have a couple of those already. Alright, I've written it all down, but is this the list you were talking about? Yes, though it's incomplete. I want you to find ingredients for monsters that aren't on this list and bring them to me. Did you get that? Ingredients that are not on the list. Make sure you don't get that wrong. Find ingredients that aren't on it. Come to report. Of course, you're also welcome to get a bunch together and report before you're completely done. However, I will need one of the ingredients as a sample, so do be careful not to eat too much. Get ingredients not on the list and come back to report, then. How many types do you want, of the ones not on this list, I mean? Can't be sure of how much is there, but I'd be happy if you found 5 or 6 new ingredients. If you find even half of that, I'd be willing to pay you for your time. Is there anything else you'd like to ask? I think we've got it. We'll look around and see what we can find. Please do. No need to rush. It's not an urgent job. Still, I can't wait to see what you report. So, yeah, I'm going to put a break right here. And we'll go a little bit further with the ingredients before I actually completely break the video.
Come on!
Edge, and I was out here only searching for ingredients. Quite a payout. Okay, I did a bit of exploring off-screen. Basically, I went to every single place you can go, killing stuff that I could. You may have seen the Shining Palm battle beforehand. All in the search for food items. And unfortunately, so far, I'm having trouble finding a source of savory pinions. I'm hoping one will manifest as we progress through the chapter, but before we wrap up this video, there's something we need to do. So, if you notice, Varin Lighthouse, or however the hell this is pronounced. Ignoring the plant. I should mention there is a Genus Blazer that's an armor for men in this area. It's in a chest off to the side. If you grab it, then... hey, free armor for Agate. So, how many of you guys remember this place from the first chapter? And I'm still getting those Steam notifications visible. So, it was the Yankers, I believe, that took over this place. Well, a lot happened here. We had to clear out monsters and stuff. But most importantly of all, let's check out on the old codger here. Still hurts a bit, eh? No use, can't strain myself any further. Hi, Mr. Vote. It's been a while. Well, it's you Bracer Kids again. Still full of vim and vinegar, I see. Yeah, now I remember. You were knocked out during that whole mess with the intelligence goons. Yeah, this is Mr. Vote, I don't know how his name is supposed to be pronounced, but the Lighthouse Keeper. How are you these days? Still hanging in there? I've been alright mostly, though recently I... what's wrong? Are you alright? It's my bum back. Can't seem to shake this pain. Anytime I bend at all, it's like someone's driving a spike through my spine. Sounds pretty painful. Can't you take medicine for that or anything? Been dealing with this pain since you were in diapers, I'll have you know. I'll not waste time trying to cure it now. It'll go away on its own, I'll see to that. Unfortunately, I can't afford to sit around resting for too long right now. Huh? This is part of the same line, isn't it? Is there something you need done? Matter of fact, there is. I was right in the middle of an important job when you stormed in here. You know there are ornaments used in the lighthouse, right? I swapped the parts out for new ones, but I ain't given them all a test yet. It sounds like it could be a problem. No worries, this is my responsibility. Wouldn't be much of a lighthouse keeper if I asked someone else to do it. I'll just take it slow and easy and keep my back straight. I see. Well, don't strain yourself, okay? You don't want to make it worse. You don't need to worry on that score, little miss. I know my body. Listen to me, go on. Sorry to chew your ears off. Good luck with your work, Bracers. Thanks. Take care. Oh yes, one moment. I almost forgot. What is it? About testing them ornaments. There's a manual on the bookshelf there with details on how to do it. If you're curious, feel free to take a look. Huh? Sure, I guess. It's an important job to be sure, but it's mostly just flipping switches. Anyone could do it if they read the manual, I reckon. You know, do you think, just maybe, he's being the most passive-aggressive old fart in the universe and asking us to help him out? Ain't no maybe about it. Something wrong? Nothing. See ya. So, control device. Set the beacon. Set on to initiate beacon. Adjust orbital level, stabilizer mechanism. Select on to activate beacon. So, you want activation switch on, then connection quartz on. How do I... okay, there we go. If you think, is it broken? Consult troubleshooting section. Switch isn't flipping. Set amplitude to low. Will not activate at a higher setting than low. Output is zero. Set to higher value. Resulting will be a zero and output will stop. Keeps dropping without any error. Multiple possibilities. Stabilizer setting. Can't connect the quartz. Amplitude must be set to high. Contents in the manual may be changed at any time without notice. Sublime. here's where we are. And I think we just have to keep ramping up its power like this. Whoa. Fire in the hole! Okay, it's not exploding after all. You did it. So, can we leave it alone now, right? You can. It's in diagnostic mode. It'll stop on its own in a little while. Okay, then. Still, I'm impressed. You managed to figure out with nothing more than the manual. It wasn't easy, to be honest. And it just broke, damn it. Hey, looks like it stopped. Yes, indeed. The diagnostic's done, and there were no problems to report. It's been mighty neighborly of you to do this all for me. Sorry to put you through all this trouble. It's fine. No need to thank us. Just make sure you take it easy on your back. No. I can't let you go without expressing a little bit of my gratitude. Here. So those are two different types of bait. These are, some bait for sea fishing. You can land some real whoppers on the cliffs near the lighthouse. Should try if you got the time. Thanks. Anyway, should be moving along, but... anything else we can do for you? Got all I need, little miss. However, it's good of you to ask. Very, very important. Shows you have a heart that cares for others, as any modern bracer should, just like the bracers of old. Well, thanks. You make sure to remember that attitude, dear. Now, safe travels. So, I don't know what all the reward is for that, but it's a hidden quest, as you can see. There's no notification that it's there. You have to come here on your own in order to find it. So I'm gonna cut to the Bracer Guild. I'll see you in a second. Okay, here we are in the Bracer Guild. We need to talk to Elnin and report. So, we got... test run. Grand total. Not a bad chunk of change. And a seaside monster. That puts us at 22, which I think is the max you can have at this point. And we got a decent chunk of gold, like I was saying. All in all, I'm satisfied, and we'll call it quits here. We'll pick up with the investigation next time. But until then, I'm the Hero of Light. Thanks for watching.